For centuries, pneumatic tube networks have been used to transport everything from money to aircraft parts. So why not lab specimens? Today, a system just like these is used to speed drug discovery at Novartis. We call it lab-to-lab.
Pneumatic networks have been used in pharmaceutical manufacturing, but it is just now catching on in industry labs. Before lab-to-lab, Novartis scientists had to hand carry their sample to their testing equipment, equipment which was far from their experiments. Now, using lab-to-lab, scientists can send samples without leaving their lab, and we can see where everything is at, simply by viewing the lab-to-lab dashboards. The system offers direct connection to a variety of testing machines. Any scientist can walk to a lab-to-lab sender station 24 hours a day and submit a sample for a wide variety of analytical methods, such as liquid chromatography, mass spectrometry, nuclear magnetic resonance, and other proteomic tests. A barcode tells the computer which protocol to use. The system uses the power of air to send the sample through the network of tubing to the right destination. Once the sample arrives at the analytical instrument, it is automatically processed without human intervention, and reliable, high-quality data is sent to the scientist and anyone else who needs it.
Lab-to-lab provides scientists with less interruptions and more time with their experiments. It saves each chemist about 15 minutes per day, which might not sound like much, but with 300 chemists in Basel and 100 chemists in Cambridge, that is 100 hours per day saved. That adds up. This convenience provides the opportunity to dedicate more time to the design, synthesis, and purification of molecules.